Bonjour Yasavin, I hope you're well. Today we're going to continue our subject on physical description. By the end of this lesson, you will have expanded your vocabulary to describe someone and you will have worked on your listening skills to extract information about somebody's physical appearance. For this lesson, you will need some paper and a pen. To start, copiez la date, soulignez avec une règle et écrivez le titre « Description physique de ». For your starter, you need to click on one of the links that you can see in the box. These links are also available on class charts. You can choose to do the secured or the master task, orange or red. Once finished, don't forget to upload a picture or screenshot of your score on class charts. Now we're going to look at some more detailed vocabulary to describe someone. Il a des lunettes, which means he has glasses. Il a un chapeau, he has a hat. Il a une barbe, he has a beard. Il a une moustache, he has a moustache. All of them are male, so we use il for them, which means he. I hope you remember that. If we were talking about a female, we would have to use the pronoun elle. So elle a des lunettes, which means she has glasses. Elle a un chapeau, elle a une barbe. Elle a une moustache. When you want to say that someone is bald, you can say in French, il est chauve, or for a female, elle est chauve, okay? Which means he is bald and she is bald. Notice here that we use est, which means is. So, il est means he is, and elle est means she is. Finally, to talk about somebody's size, you can say for a female, elle est petite, which means she is small. And for a male, you would say il est petit, which means he is small. Here, the adjective changes when it is feminine, okay? You need to add the e at the end. For somebody who's tall, for a male, we would say il est grand, which means he is tall. And if you wanted to say that about a woman or a girl, you would say elle est grande. And once again, we add the E at the end when we talk about a female. When you want to talk about somebody's shape, you can say il est mince, which means he is slim. And for a female, it's elle est mince. Notice here that the adjective mince does not change. And you can also say about someone that they are overweight, il est gros. And for a female, it's elle est grosse. And notice here that the adjective changes for female. You add an S and an E at the end, okay? So it makes grosse and not gros. Devine qui c'est. We are going to play Guess Who again, but this time you will hear me describe the celebrity and you have to choose which one it is and write a name next to the number. For this activity, you will need a vocabulary from previous slides and previous lessons, so you can go backwards and listen to the vocabulary again and rehearse pronouncing it before you start this exercise. You can choose to do the mastered or the secured task, either give 5 answers or 8. I will first give you an example. So I will say, numéro 1, elle a les cheveux marrons et courts. Elle a les cheveux marrons et courts. The answer for this is Lupita Nyong'o, because I said she has short and brown hair. Okay, so what I would like you to do is write down on your paper the numbers from 1 to 8. For number 1, you already have the answer. You write down Lupita Nyong'o. And we are going to try to do the other ones. Let's go. Numéro 2. Il est chauve et il a les yeux marrons. Il est chauve et il a les yeux marrons. Numéro 3. Elle est blonde et elle a des lunettes. Elle est blonde et elle a des lunettes. Numéro 4. Elle a les cheveux roux et elle a un chapeau. Elle a les cheveux roux et elle a un chapeau. Numéro 5. Il est roux et il a des lunettes. Il est roux et il a des lunettes. Numéro 6. Il a une barbe et il a les cheveux marrons. Il a une barbe et il a les cheveux marron. Numéro 7. Il a une barbe et il a les cheveux roux. Il a une barbe et il a les cheveux roux. Numéro 8. Elle a un chapeau et elle a les cheveux longs. Elle a un chapeau et elle a les cheveux longs. Right, don't forget year 7 to upload a picture of your answers on class charts. Right, this is the end of our lesson, year 7. Don't forget to upload a picture of your word world score on class charts, as well as a picture of your answers for the listening activity. Merci year 7, au revoir.